بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين. نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ به من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله تعالى فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت، وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله وخيرته من خلقه أجمعين. بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة، فاللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك عليه وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين، وعمن تبع هداه واستنى بسنته وسلِّم تسليماً كثيراً. أما بعد، عباد الله، Dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, He said in the Quran, which is the words of Allah, as I mentioned in Friday's speech. So you cannot say beautiful verse or nice verse, because all the verses from number one to the last one, all beautiful, nice, because it's the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was saying to the companion, what is the best ayah in the Quran? So he said, when he asked the companion about the best ayah in the Quran, or the story of Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he was a caretaker of the storage room of the wheat and the food, which is they for zakat, they keep it storage room for zakat. So he was guarding this room. The door is locked, he's outside. And then he heard something inside. Room is locked. So he opened the door, he found a man there, he tied him. And he said to him, I'll take you to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, I am a poor man, I have hungry children, I came to take something to eat. Leave me, I promise I will not come back again. So he felt sorry for him and he let him go. Next day, room is closed, no windows, only hole for ventilation. And then Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu heard somebody inside. He opened the room, he found the same man, he tied him, and he told him the same story. He said, okay, let go, don't come back again. Third day, same story. So he said to him, this is the third time. You okay? This is the third time you tricked me and you broke your promise. I am taking you to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He will deal with you. He said, please don't take me to the Prophet and I'll give you a tip. He said, what is it? He said, I will teach you a verse from the Quran. If you recite it, this verse, the shaitan will be away from you. He said, okay, tell me what's the ayah. He said, Ayat al-Kursi. So Abu Huraira, he promised him that if you told me what the ayah, let you go. So he let him go. So Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He wants to confirm that the message from that man or old man, was it right or wrong? So Abu Huraira told the Prophet the whole story. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he smiled and he said, do you know who's that man, Abu Huraira? He said, no. He said, that's the shaitan himself. That was the shaitan himself. And he told you the truth while he's the biggest liar. Sadaqaka wa huwa kadhub. He is the liar, but he told you the truth. This ayah is the greatest ayah in the Quran. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, kalamullah, all the Quran, fihi shifa'un wa rahmah. There is treatment and mercy on the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In a verse, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ma farratna fi al-kitabi min shay. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the meaning of this ayah, that in this book Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned everything. That means not like now when people said we want to add something in the book, or not in the book, in the Islam. Can you make sure the room is open, the light? Please, JazakAllah. Add the Mi'raj. When people add something in Islam, and you told them that this is bid'ah, it's not right, because our Islam is completed, Allah perfect, the Quran and the Deen. And when the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he gave the last speech in Arafah, he told them that listen to my advices, as I might not see you from after this year. Ayah in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa radhitu lakum al-islam deena. Allahu Akbar. This ayah in Surah Al-Ma'idah, when Allah said to the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Arafah, when he was going to Muzdalifah, next day is the Eid day. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to the Ummah, today I had completed your deen, your religion, and I perfect وَأَتْمَمْتُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَةِ. My grace was perfect upon you. It's completed. And I am satisfied that Islam will be your religion. One of the Yahud rabbi, he came to Hazrat Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala, just to know, what is your deen? What is your religion? To know what the non-Muslim, when they talk fair about your religion, when they speak injustice about your religion. He said to Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa arda, this rabbi, he said, Ya Umar, Umar at that time was the Khalifa al-Muslimin, Amir al-Mu'mineen. He said, do you know, Umar, you have a verse in the Quran. It was revealed on us, Bani Israel, in the Torah, we will make that day Eid for us. So Hazrat Umar said, which ayah, or which verses? He said, the ayah saying, today I have completed your religion. And I completed your religion, and I completed my grace upon you, and I am satisfied that Islam will be your religion. Because in the other prophets, Bani Israel, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in each prophet tongues, that prophet say that there is a prophet comes after him. There will be a prophet comes after him. All the prophets, they give a good news that there is a prophet comes after him. Up to Jesus, son of Mary, peace be upon them, he said to Bani Israel that there will be a prophet after me named Ahmed, which is Muhammad and Ahmed, same meaning. So when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came as a prophet, he said, I am the good news of my brother Jesus. And I am the dua of my father Ibrahim. Because Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he was built the holy house of Kaaba, said, Rabbana wab'ath fihim rasulan min anfusihim. Oh Allah, send from Mecca a prophet from themselves, not from outside, from themselves, from people of Mecca. So he was the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and he was the good news of Isa, Jesus, son of Mary, peace be upon them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came, and the last ayat in the Quran, Allah did not say that today I had completed your religion and my ni'mat or my bounty or grace was perfected upon you and there will be a prophet after Muhammad. No. Allah said, Islam is your religion. Khalas. It's the final prophet. That's the good news. So this rabbi say to Umar radiallahu ta'ala, if that ayah was sent down or revealed to Bani Israel, to us, we will make that day Eid. So Umar radiallahu anhu said, I know when that ayah was revealed. And it was revealed in the Eid day, which is Eid al-Adha, you know, the second day of Arafah. So it's Eid for Ummah. So he said to the Jew, Rabbi, it is Eid. The ayah was revealed in Eid. So now you find the non-Muslims, when they read the Quran, and they read the authentic hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you find them amazed. That's great Quran. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ, that means everything in your religion, you'll find it in the Quran. You don't need to add anything. You'll find it in the Quran. And when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned a hadith, a great hadith, which has happened today and yesterday and maybe a few hundred years ago, when he said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, one day some of my ummah will fill his stomach by the beautiful, nice, delicious food and set on a very luxury cushion or sofa, and then he will sit or rely on his arm like this, and he starts saying, we only believe in the Quran. Whatever in the Quran, we will follow. Whatever not in the Quran, we are not following. The meaning is what? We are not following the hadith. We are not following the hadith. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَلَا إِنِّي أُوتِيتُ الْقُرْآنَ, that he said, I have the Qur'an, and similar to the Qur'an, and similar to the Qur'an, and similar to the Qur'an. Which is what? All his hadith is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it knows the Qur'an. It's not, it wasn't Qur'an. It wasn't Qur'an. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why whatever we need from our deen, you will find it in Kitabullah wa sunnata Rasulihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa sunnata Rasulihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You'll find now so many people in our ummah, especially those who got high educated, said, no, only taking the Quran. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, in the Quran there is an ayah. Allah said, مَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Whatever the Prophet told you, you have to follow. That's ayah from the Quran. Then, if you follow the Quran, that's the ayah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, whatever the Prophet said, don't do it, then don't do it. That means you have to follow the Prophet. Another ayah, another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, say to the believers, to the Muslims, if you love Allah, love the Prophets, then Allah will love you and forgive your sins. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. Follow the Prophet, then Allah will love you. Why I am saying these hadith and these ayat in the Quran? Because when we talk about Prophet Jesus, son of Mary, peace be upon them, there are a lot of ayat was sent to Jesus in the Quran. In the Quran. That some Muslims, they try not to mention it. Which is in Surah Al-Hadid, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that to Isa, Jesus, son of Mary, peace be upon them. That's why when we talk about Jesus, son of Mary, in our schools, in our work, in our university, in the street, to our neighbors, we have to tell them the full story. Because they thought we are against Isa, alayhi salam. We are against Jesus. We are against Prophet Moses. We are against all prophet. No. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was the continuous, the message from Adam, Nuh, Idris to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is the message. He was the last prophet and messenger sallallahu alayhi, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in the Quran very clearly. So the ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam, and Prophet Jesus, son of Mary, peace be upon them, he was very, very, very kind and very humble and very easy man. And because of him, Allah made those who follow him kind, merciful, very care to others, those who follow him. Not the one who say we are the, for example, the crusaders, and we have to kill anybody against us. And you know what they've done to in Jerusalem, in Damascus, in Aleppo, in Syria, in Palestine, Jerusalem. They killed thousands and thousands of Muslims. They say with the name of God. There is nothing calling kill by the name of God. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if one person embrace Islam, better than 100 camels. At that time, camels is worth 100 cars now. That mean, if Allah say kill, that mean kill. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam, Prophet Jesus, son of Mary, that وَجَعَلْنَا فِي قُلُوبِ الَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُ. that we made in the heart of those who follow Jesus, son of Mary. Rafa, kindness, merciful. Up to, Allah said up to the day of judgment. And he said to Isa alayhi salam in another verse, وَجَاعِلِ الَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوكَ فَوْقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Jesus, son of Mary, peace be upon them, that I made those who follow you, not follow you, that means he's son of God. No, they say he's the prophet of Allah. He said, Allah said, Allah will make them the superior ever above those who disbelieve on you until the day of judgment. When I say that, I want you to compare what Allah said in the Quran about those who follow the Prophet and the Messenger of Allah, Jesus, son of Mary, now, 2020, Muslims kill each other. Who solved our problems? The Christian who followed Jesus. Now, when the German counselor, Miracle, she said that how shame Arabs, Muslims, they have thousands and thousands and thousands of acres of land. Nobody live on it. And they close their borders in the face of their Syrian brothers, Muslims. Until we came and we shipped them to Germany, 50,000 Muslims. It is a shame. It is a shame to the Muslim Ummah. When we close our land, say, no, this land is not yours. And then we say, those are kuffar. Those are fiddles. Those are not Muslims. They send ship, flights, take the Muslim, poor Muslim, from the massacres of their own Muslim president to our country. And when they came in Canada, New Zealand, Australia, England, Germany, all these countries, the prime ministers, queen, kings, president, they went themselves to say welcome to our land. And that's nothing, there's nothing new. It's nothing new. Don't say, oh, this is new. No. In the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Mecca, before he immigrated to Medina, when his own people, who's their own people? Abu Lahab. Abu Lahab, he's the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to say, if not Abu Talib, I will kill Muhammad, my nephew. Al-Walid ibn al-Mughira, father of Hazrat Khalid ibn Walid, he has his son, Muslim. Abu Jahl himself, he has one stepbrother and another brother. He's got two brothers, one stepbrother from mother, and he got another brother. Both of them embrace Islam. He tied them. Hazrat Umar ibn Khattab, before he embraced Islam, his brother Zayd, he was Muslim. So they used to torture their own people, and they asked them, they forced them to leave the Islam and come back to kufr, go back to jahiliyyah, go back to our idols. Go back to our idols. While in Mecca, at that time, 1450 years ago, in Mecca, there is no place on earth they have freedom in deen but Mecca. If you go to Syria, you must be Christian. If you go to Yemen, you must be a Jew. If you go to Iraq, to Iran, you must be Pharisee, worshipping the fire. If you go to Egypt, you must be Orthodox Christian. That you must be. But in Mecca, at that time, any religion welcome. Christian, Jew, Pharisee, idols, and then you say, I want this my God. Can I leave it in Kaaba? Yeah, it's okay. As long as you pay, leave it. Freedom of speech, freedom of religion. All religion in Mecca, the only place at that time, is only Mecca. Not in Europe, not in America, no, in Mecca. You allow in Mecca to worship anything you like, but not Islam. When the Prophet ﷺ came, they said to him, Ya Muhammad, O Muhammad, choose any other thing but not one God. Say anything but not one God. Because the words one God is making those people who suck the blood of the poor people like now, we make them equal. No, we need people high and we need people low. We need those to be slave to those. We need those to give order to those. In Islam, we have to think high and low. We are all equal. So they said, no, that's impossible. Choose anything else, but not Islam. So where is your freedom? He said, no. Can I be free like the Christian, like the Jew, like the Pharisee, like the Majus, like the Sikh, like the Hindu? No, not in Mecca. To be Muslim, no. So when they start killing their own people, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he did not say to them, go to Syria, go to Palestine, go to Iraq, go to Yemen. While he said about Yemeni people, he said they are the good heart ever. No. He said, go to Abyssinia, to Al-Habasha, which is now called Ethiopia. Go to Abyssinia. And he told the reason between two brackets. What is the reason? Their king, a religion person, believe in the Bible. If you tell this story to your mate and your colleagues and your neighbor, do you know 1450 years ago, our prophet say to his follower, and among those people, the daughters of Rasulullah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his daughter, Hazrat Usman, was married to daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said to them, go to Abyssinia, not go to the Arabs in Syria, or Arab in Iraq, or Arab in Yemen, or Arab in Egypt. No, he said, go to Abyssinia, cross the river and go, cross the Red Sea and go, at night time, secretly. And not only that, when the Quraysh, people of Quraysh, they knew that they left to Abyssinia, they said, oh, we have to follow them, bring them back. Bring them back. So when they arrived to Abyssinia, I want you to know what the Prophet said. He said to them, their king believe in the Bible. If you read the right Bible, like Parnabas Bible, you will see what is the truth. There is no difference between the Bible and Islam at all. So when they went there, an asylum seeker, they arrived, then people of Quraysh, very clever. People of Quraysh, they're very clever. They said, we know the king of Abyssinia, his name was An-Najashi. He loves animal skin. He loves animal skin. Tiger, lion, camel, sheep, cow, he loves it. And they used to sell them a lot in Mecca. They said, we know his best friend was Hazrat Amr ibn al-As. Amr ibn al-As, he was Kafir at that time. And then he embraced Islam later on. But how Hazrat Amr radiallahu anhu, how he embraced Islam? How he embraced Islam? So they said, Najashi, the king, his best friend is Amr. So Amr, you will be our ambassador to the king. Take as much as you like from the dry animal skin as a gift to him. Then when he see the gifts, he said, my friend, what do you want? He said, we have some asylum seekers, send them back to me. So he went to him and he said, Amr, my best friend, what have you brought to me from Mecca? He said, the skin, animal skin you love. And he show him crocodile skin, lion, tiger, camels, lovely. So I love them. He said, then I accept your gift. What do you want? How come you here now? It's not time for business. Usually they come in the season of business. He said, we have some rebels. Some of our people, about 80. They ran away from us. They brought a new religion and they broke our unity. And they come here as refugees in your country. We want them back. He said, yeah, but I have to know what is their excuse. Call them. Who was their Amir? Ja'far radiallahu anhu, Hazrat Ja'far ibn Abi Talib. Even when Uthman, Hazrat Uthman, he was among them, but Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, he was the Amir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Bani Hashim a talent and skill of speech, talking, hikmah. This is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not from them, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he brought them, they came. Hazrat Uthman, Mus'ab ibn Umair, all the Sahaba, and they were frightened, they will send us back. So Amr, he was from Quraysh. And Quraysh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about them, they are very good in argument. They can twist words. إِنَّهُمْ قَوْمٌ خَسِمُونَ. They are very good in argument. When you argue with someone, say, oh, you're from Quraysh. Because he broke all the dates and he made words. So he said, what's this man? So when Amr ibn al-As, he was one of those people. Very good in argument. And his excuse always ready, and he had the best sense of humor. But now Amr, he's against Ja'far. Alhamdulillah. Ja'far came with the words of Allah. Amr ibn al-As at that time came with the words of the shaitan. So he said, those people, they did this, as I told you. So the king said to them, first, why your prophet or your man send you to me? They said, because you believe in the Bible. Imanuka bil Injil. He said, how your prophet know the Bible? So they said, our prophet is the good news of Prophet Jesus, son of Mary. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command us to believe in Jesus, Moses, David, Ibrahim, Ishaq, Zachariah, Yahya. So when they told him these names, he was impressed. He said, who taught you all these names? I know Mecca people, they don't know Jahiliyyah, Jahil. They don't know these things. They said, in the Quran. He said, what is the Quran? Then Amr ibn al-As said, Quran is only a few words. Few words. So he said to him, O king, don't listen to them. Just send them to me chained. He said, no. They told me something, stopped me from taking, send them back. He said, what? He said, they say, my faith and believe in Bible. What does mean? Rahmah, merciful, and kindness. and passion. Can you say passion?
Compassion.
Huh? Compassion. Yeah? So he said, by these things, I have to listen to them. Because I believe in the Injil. I believe in the Bible. So then he said, oh, you don't know what they say about Jesus. He said, what are they say about Jesus? They say he's all a human being, he's a slave. He's a slave. That he want to tell them that they humiliate Jesus, your God. And as you know, the Najashi, at that time, yes, he was believing cross, that the God and the Holy Spirit and Son of God, he believed in that. So he said, tell me, what are you saying about Jesus? So Ja'far was panicking. He said, if I say, oh, you know, he was good man, and he said, I'm going to tell him what's in the Quran, the truth. The truth. Now, the place where they say the throne of Najashi, not like our kings nowadays, and they brought the poem, and they brought the singers and sing to the king. No, at that time he used to, the priests and monks around him, because they believe in Christianity. So what happened? He said, we say about Jesus exactly what Allah the Lord say about him in the Quran. He said, then tell me. So Najashi was listening, and then he recited the verses from Surah Maryam. وَذْكُرْ فِي كِتَابِ مَرْيَمْ إِذْ انْتَبَذَتْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا مَكَانًا شَرْقِيًّا. And if you know the Arabic language, and you recite Surah Maryam, just close your eyes. Imagination, you imagine Makan al Sharqiyah, from the east place. Allah mentioned even the corner. East, west, north, south. Allah say from the east. Makan al Sharqiyah. فَاتَّخَذَتْ مِنْ دُونِهِمْ حِجَابًا. That she was, there is a bar or
screen
between her and other people. فَاتَّخَذَتْ مِنْ دُونِهِمْ حِجَابًا. And I sent my messenger, Jibreel alayhi salam, to her. When she seen him, قالت, she said to him, if you fear Allah, don't touch me, don't come near to me. He said, don't worry. I am the angel that Allah sent me to you to make you have a birth of the greatest creature. She said, how can, while I am very clean, pure woman, and no man touched me before? He said, that is the kalima, that's the word of Allah. And the soul of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the spirit of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ruh wa kalimatan min. And then he blow from here. And then be, and it will be. And then he told them the story. When they finished reciting this ayat, they look at Najashi, tears. They look at the priest behind him, tears. And that's exactly what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in Surah At-Tawbah. لَتَجِدَنَّ أَقْرَبَهُمْ مَوَدَّةً لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّا نَصَارَى ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ مِنْهُمْ قِسِّيسِينَ وَرُهْبَانًا. بعدين وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا إِلَى مَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ تَرَى أَعْيُنَهُمْ تَفِيضُ مِنَ الدَّمْعِ مِمَّا عَرَفُوا مِنَ الْحَقِّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that you will find the closest kindship to the believers, those who say we are Christian. Why? Because priests and monks among them, the follower of Jesus, son of Mary, peace be upon them. When they've heard Allah said about them, when they've heard the Quran, you will find their eyes full of tears because they knew it is the truth. And they say, oh Allah, forgive us. Oh Allah, grant us the Jannah. They knew. So when the follower of the monks and the priests of the Abyssinia in Ethiopia, when they've heard the Quran, every one of them, tears. And what Hazrat Ja'far used to talk about? Talk about what? Quran. About who? About Jesus. And about his mother Mary. At that time, the Jew, they used to say, oh, Maryam did a mistake. Maryam committed a sins. Maryam has an affair. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show and proof that she was innocent and she's pure until the day of judgment. And her son, pure and kind. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَجَاعِلُ الَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوكَ, that I will make those who follow you, Jesus, follow you in the right way, that he's a prophet and messenger of Allah, above the non-believer until the day of judgment. Until the day of judgment. Salamu alayhi. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased of him and his mother, inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with him and with all the prophet in Jannat al-Firdaus, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. And we witness that we believe in Jesus, son of Mary. We believe his mother is innocent. We believe he is the kalima and the ruh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we believe on all the prophets that Allah mentioned them in the Quran. If we have a doubt in one prophet, that means we are not Muslims. We are not Muslims. That's why when the companion, peace be upon them, or may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with them, they start talking about the prophets, or Prophet Muhammad, he's better, he said, don't say that. And Allah send ayah, the last verse in Surah Al-Baqarah, لَا نُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِّن رُسُلِهِ, that we have no difference between any of Allah's messengers and prophets. Allah knows who is the best. Allah knows who is better. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah Al-Isra, Asa, maybe Allah will grant you maqaman mahmuda. So there is maqam mahmud, which is mahmud, blessed, recommended position in Jannah for one person. Allah didn't say it's for you, Muhammad. He said, no. He said to him, pray at night. أقم الصلاة طرفي النهار وزلفا من الليل. Allah said to him, oh Muhammad, do the namaz at night and daytime and read the Quran and pray Fajr on time. Maybe. Asa, maybe. Allah will grant you that location, Mahmud, in Jannah. He didn't say it's for you. So if Allah said it's for you, then say, oh Muhammad. So Allah said, the prophets and messengers, لا نفرق بين أحد من الرسل. وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. So now when you listen about our prophet and messenger, Jesus, son of Mary, and we believe that he is a prophet and messenger from Allah, then if you know his real story and you believe on him 100%, then you will feel not shy. You will feel a sin when you say Merry Christmas. You feel it's a sin. Because you say, how come I say to them, Happy birthday of Son of God. God has a son, he was born this day, Merry Christmas. So I don't believe that he's Son of God. I believe he is Son of Mary. I believe he is the Word of Allah. I believe he is the Spirit of Allah. I believe he came from the soul of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows how. Nobody knows. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If even when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Jew, Rabbi, ask him. Tell us about the ruh. Everybody now here has a soul. We have ruh inside us. Tell us, what is this? What did he say? وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ. They ask you about the ruh, the soul, the spirit. Say, قُلِ الرُّوحِ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. That the soul is something to do with Allah. I can't interfere in this knowledge. It's above my myself. It's Allah's knowledge. This is one of the secrets. What is Allah's secret, subhanahu wa ta'ala? They're trying now to know what about the ruh, how it comes in, comes out, when it goes out. They put x-ray, they put people dying in scan, they put them in MRI to see how the ruh comes out. Nobody knows. قُلْ الرُّوح مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. Nothing to do with it. Nothing to do with the ruh, with the soul. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, قُلْ الرُّوح مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. So when you say, how come he's the ruh of Allah? What does it mean he's the ruh? He's the ruh of Allah. We believe he's the spirit of Allah. He comes from the ruh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Adam alayhi salam, Allah say, وَأَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I blow in Adam from Allah. From Allah. So spirit. So we are all son of Adam. We came from Allah, spirit as well. But we don't know how. Like now, we don't know what is the air. We don't know what is the oxygen. But we believe there is an oxygen now. We believe if I send a message now, it will reach you in less than a second. As you believe in my WhatsApp, in my text message, in my Instagram, we believe that Isa alayhi salam is the spirit of Allah and messenger of Allah, but not the son of Allah. That's why we say to the brothers, when you say Merry Christmas, that means you say Son of God birthday. That's the meaning. That is the meaning. That's why we don't say it. Not because we disbelieve in Jesus. No. Because we love Jesus. We respect Jesus. We believe in Jesus as a messenger of Allah and son of Mary. Peace be upon her. The virgin ever. And we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him up to him, and he will not crucify. That is the faith of Muslim. So when Najashi, we go back to Najashi, because there is a story behind Najashi. There is something behind Najashi, which is so many Muslims, they don't know it. When Najashi heard the Quran, he said, I am not giving them back. Even if you give me mountain of gold, not skin, animal skin. He said, Amr, take the animal skin back. I don't need them. If the price of this to give those people back, no. He said, why? He said, Allah will ask me about them in the day of judgment. That is the iman. That is the belief. That is the belief. Now, if he send them to Egypt or to Syria or to Palestine or to Iraq or to Yemen, they will take some pennies, pound, and then send them back. Now, if they tell the British government now here or in Germany that send the Syrian, Afghani, Algerian, Libyan, those refugees, send them back to us, they say no. We will boycott. He said, boycott. We will not give you oil. Don't give us oil. We're not giving them back. That's the difference between those who follow Jesus, son of Mary, peace be upon them. That's the difference. Their iman in Jesus, son of Mary, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if they don't believe as son of God, as son of Mary, he is son of God, but their belief in the Bible and their belief in him himself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala transplant the kindness and compassion and the mercy in their hearts. And you can see now, people dying in the sea, in the Mediterranean, they came from Africa. Came from Africa to go to Europe. Why you came from Africa by sea and you dying by Malta, by Sardinia, by Italy, by Sicily? Why? Because their own people killing them. Their own cousins, their own family, their own tribe. They take their land, take their wealth, take their land, take their money, and then they make them as a slave. They want freedom. So they leave to Europe. What's in Europe? In Africa, 10 times rich than Europe. In Africa. But few people control the land and make other slaves. So Muslims start looking for freedom, and the freedom were in the Christian countries. Allah will ask us in the day of judgment. Wallahi. Allah will ask us in the day of judgment. And alhamdulillah, from the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find those who came immigrant to these countries, they spread the Islam in this area. So An-Najashi, he said to Ja'far radiallahu anhu, Ja'far, I'll tell you something about Ja'far. Ja'far, he was the cousin of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was a brother of, eldest brother of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala. Ja'far, he is from all Bani Hashim. He is the one looks like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in everything. In everything. His face, his body, he's walking, he's talking. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, أَشْبَهْتَ خَلْقِي وَخُلُقِي. You are like me in my looking and my manners. Ja'far, you are like me in my looking, my feature and my manners. Ja'far Tayyar. Tayyar means what? When in the Mu'ta in Jordan, when they had a fight, the battle of Mu'ta, they chopped his arm from here and arm from here, and they killed him. So Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him wings in Jannah. He fly in Jannah wherever he wish. So they call Tayyar. Tayyar is the flyer. Ja'far radiallahu anhu. So Najashi said to Ja'far, you have the permission anytime to come to me. Don't knock the door, just go in. And then he gave the order in the palace. If Ja'far comes anytime, day or night, let him come in. Now the Najashi, he was Christian. He's heard the Quran. He's heard the Quran. In the Battle of Badr, the year 2 in Hijrah, the news came from those businessmen, the travelers, the caravans in Ethiopia. The news came that there were a battle, a great battle between Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, and Quraysh. And they were 313, and those they were 997 or 1,000 something. And the Muslims, or the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they won that battle, and they were the superior. So when the Sahaba in Abyssinia, when they've heard this news, Ja'far say, I must tell the king this good news. So he entered to the palace, nobody stopped him. He entered inside the room of Najashi. He found him prostrating, sujood. So Hazrat Ja'far was sitting like this, standing like this. He's waiting. I know he's a Christian, but maybe they do sujood like us, so he didn't. So he was standing like this, waiting for him. And then when he got up from sujood, he looked at Ja'far and he was tearing. He said, O king, why are you crying? He said, I've heard the news that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam won the battle in Mecca, in Badr. So I did sujood to Allah. I did sujood to Allah. So Ja'far, he knew that he's a Muslim. And then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as I told you, he's a very kind Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He heard that one of the Muslims in Abyssinia, one from Mecca, who stayed in Abyssinia, he married to Abu Sufyan's daughter, Ramla. Shafakumullah. He left Islam and he became Christian. They didn't kill him. They didn't kill him and they didn't assassinate him. They left him. So his wife now became forbidden. He's not allowed to be with his wife. She said, if you want Christianity, then you're not my husband anymore. So she was a daughter of one of Mecca leader, Abu Sufyan. You know Abu Sufyan? So when the Prophet heard that, and they've heard that, her heart was broken. So he sent to An-Najashi. Look at the respect. If you wanted to learn the diplomatic way, look at the respect. A letter came to An-Najashi, to the king. When he opened it, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Najashi permission to marry the Muslim woman, but she is under his custody, under his rule. She's in your country. He doesn't want to her straight away or no. You are the king. She's under your rules now. She's one of your citizens. I want you to be my attorney to ask her if she accepts me as a husband. So he called Ramla and he said, Rasulullah, peace be upon him, send me a letter and ask permission if you accept to marry him. She said, who is better than Rasulullah? She accepted to marry Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then Najashi paid her 400 dirham at that time as a dowry, mahar, to her. So he was her attorney, Najashi. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, look how he contact the king. He didn't say, just send somebody to her. No, there is respect, there is the rules. The Prophet was the leader in Medina, Najashi was the leader in Abyssinia. That's how to do the diplomatic way. Islam is not cowboy. Just could be a Muslim and wear this and kill that. No. Islam is rules. Islam is manners. Now, the best bit in An-Najashi is something else. Now, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after the battle of Al-Khandaq and Ahzab, which is the troops, when they dig the trench, and then Mecca and all Arabs, they lost, and Allah gave the support to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam by the wind. وَجُنُودًا لَمْ تَرَوْهَا, that Allah say, you can't see this army of Allah, and the wind was one of the biggest army. The wind took all the tent away, so they left back. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, from now on, they will not attack us in Medina. We will go to them. What happened? Amr ibn al-As, he was disappointed. And he said, we tried with Muhammad 3, 4, 5 battles, only little. And he won. And we are the greatest nation in Mecca. So I'm not staying in Mecca. Muhammad is coming to Mecca. I'm not staying. So where to go? He took another one, named Uthman. And they said, let us go to Abyssinia. I have a friend there. He wants to seek asylum as well. But this time he is asylum what? Not Muslim. So he came again to An-Najashi. When he came to Najashi, Najashi asked him again, what brought you to my country again, O Amr? He said to him, O King, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم محمد is winning in all times and I was frightened if I am in Mecca and he invade Mecca I will be a hostage or a prisoner so I decide to run away I don't want to see him I don't want to see his followers so An-Najash told him Amr I know Allah granted you a clear brain you are an intelligent person Wallahi he is the messenger of Allah received the message from Allah like Jesus and Moses don't miss this opportunity Amr go back to him so he looked at him and said are you serious king he said Wallahi he is the messenger of Allah and you missed a lot from his company go now and embrace Islam. Now, Amr ibn al-As, he is the one who brought Islam to Egypt. As the ulama, the scholar, they say, in the Day of Judgment, all the Egyptian Muslim will come in the scale of Hazrat Amr ibn al-As. But Amr ibn al-As and the Egyptian Muslims, they will come in the scale of Najashi. He will get the reward of every Egyptian embrace Islam. An-Najashi. So Amr ibn al-As decided to go back. But he said, let me go back to Mecca first. See what's the news. So he went to Mecca. He said, where is Khalid ibn Walid? He said, we haven't seen him for a few days. So then he talked to Uthman. He said, listen, I'm going to Medina. What for? I'm going to see the Prophet. Uthman said, I will go with you as well. And then midway, they found Hazrat Khalid ibn Walid. He said, why you are here? And you look at them and they look at them. They said, what you want, exactly what you want. He said, I'm going to Medina to see the Prophet. They said, we go to the Prophet. So when they came, three of them together, the Prophet, when you see Khalid ibn Walid, and when you see Amr ibn al-As, and Uthman al-Mad'un, the Prophet said, Mecca, the heart of Mecca came to us. رَمَتْكُمْ مَكَّةِ بِفَلَذَاتِ أَكْبَارِهَا The best people of Mecca now with us. So the Prophet knew that soon he will go back to Mecca. So they embrace Islam. When they embrace Islam, Hadrat Amr radiallahu ta'ala anhu warda, he told the Prophet the story between him and Najashi. And he became Muslim because of the king's advice. When Najashi died, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet ﷺ called in Medina As-Salatu Jami'ah. That means come to the prayer. When they came, he said to them, your brother, An-Najashi of Abyssinia, passed away. I am going to lead to do Salatul Janazah. Salat al-Janazah. So the Prophet ﷺ, the first Janaza, absent janaza, was performed on Hazrat al-Najashi radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa rabbah. Now, if he's not a Muslim, will the Prophet lead them now? No. So subhanAllah, he was a king. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say to him, you are king, come to me and do. No. You are king, that's your place. So Islam or Muslims, now, if you ask any Muslim leader, he says, why you are frightened from Islam? He said, oh, those Muslims, they want to be a leader. Those Muslims, they want to be a king. Nobody wants a king. You stay king, but be a fair king. Be a just king. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them an example from Hazrat al-Najashi that his faith and his belief in the Bible and Jesus, son of Mary, and al-Injil made him in the end embrace Islam and Allah gave him the honor that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lead the janazah prayers and they call it salatul ghaib absence if somebody is not present the deceased is not present so they call it salatul ghaib the absence عادي عادي مو مشكلة مو مشكلة خليه خليه مو مشكلة. So from these lessons we have to know, we have to know what does mean Merry Christmas. Not because we are anti-Christianity or anti-Jesus or anti-Mary, no. Because we respect, we believe, we will, we love Jesus, Son of Mary, not Son of God. And because of that, our love to Jesus and to his mother, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with them and peace be upon them, will be same as our love to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to Prophet Moses, to Prophet David, and to all Prophet of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us in the day of judgment with them. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all our sins. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who listen to the talk and follow the best of the talk and follow the truth all the time. جزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.